Hey, Johannes here. Today I wanted to talk about the Season of Mastery player base and compare it to the Burning Crusade WoW Classic player base. What I found out was quite shocking, and the Season of Mastery Classic player base should be aware I will also go into what I hope Blizzard will do. This is useful info for all World of Warcraft eras, so Classic Era, Season of Mastery, Classic, and even Retail WoW. Let's dive into the video. Hey, for those that do not know me, I'm Johannes. I raid lad at 1.9 rosters a week, weekly, in Phase 6 of Classic World of Warcraft, with 6 of them being Naxx rosters, clearing weekly all bosses. I decided to continue my adventure in Season of Mastery WoW Classic, and have already 2 characters ready for raiding. If you watched my previous videos, you've already seen some raiding action, and at the moment we got 2 rosters 10 out of 10 in Molten Core. We cleared last Sunday, one-shotting everything, and did a 2-hour clear in Season of Mastery. It felt great achieving this, and can't wait to get into Blackwing Lair and hopefully do the same. The experience so far in Season of Mastery has been amazing. While making groups for the raids in Season of Mastery, it became clear fast to me that there was a lack of priests, paladins, Rester Druids and warlocks in the player base. These are the most sought after classes, and if you intend to play, try to roll those for Season of Mastery and you won't have any issues getting a raiding spot. At the moment I'm motivating my members to start leveling those, as I get about 5-10 whispers daily of rogues and hunters wanting raid spots in Classic WoW raids. Let's get into it. After most raids I went into rankings on our server Dreadnought to see what timings we got for killing certain bosses compared to others, as it was quite shocking. We had gotten the first clear 13th of the world, 5th on server Dreadnought, and the second clear was 38th world in Molten Core. And when I went to check the speed rankings, I saw that there were at the moment of preparing this video just 13 guilds clearing 10 out of 10 in Molten Core in Season of Mastery on Dreadnought. 5 being Horde and 8 Alliance. We just have our logs under one name at the moment, but this would be server 14th with our other raiding team. So I know what the player base will say, Johannes. Most players are not 60 yet and have to raid still, this is not accurate information. While I agree somewhat with that statement, I went even deeper and got on the website Ironforge Pro. The results shocked me and also made me happy we moved from Quel'Thuar back then to Dreadnought after 2 days of playing, at the start of our adventure of Season of Mastery. We had skipped 2 days there and decided together to restart on the server Dreadnought, as it had a bigger player base. Here are the player bases in Season of Mastery. I'll give my thoughts about Europe first and then America. These numbers come from Ironforge Pro. These are all players that have raided in Season of Mastery in Molten Core or Nexa to date and have logged in on worker vlogs. So it does not take into account players that have not raided yet. So from Europe, there's a clear winner player base wise, it is our PvP server called Dreadnought. With at the time of preparing this video with a player base of 1542 Alliance and 698 Horde. Next in line in PvE Season of Mastery server, Kingsfall, with 489 Alliance, and this player base almost has no Horde. Third is PvP Ironfoe, with quite a heavy Alliance influence server and player base. The last servers are really dead, with Quel'Thuar not having any logged raids yet. Phew, dodge the bullet there. Then there is Boneside and a Russian server, having just 3 logged raids from different raiders. If you're on these and want a good Season of Mastery experience going forward, I would just restart and level a new character on Dreadnought PvP. I have even heard of players making tickets asking to server transfer and Blizzard responding to them with "we are not adding them." That's not 100% accurate though, they might add it in the future. This is just what I've heard around on Reddit in the comments. Still, it is in the store if you check, but you can't activate it. Now let's quickly go over the American servers and player base in Season of Mastery. In America Classic WoW, the best player base for the server at the moment is PvP Jom Gabar in US East. It is again heavy Alliance sided, with 69% being Alliance and just 31% being Horde that have raided. Next to that, we have PvE Shadowstrike, and this is also on US East. It has the same pattern as the Europe servers, with just 2 servers being the most populated player base wise that have raided so far. Next to this we have servers on the US West that really spread out their player base. Mutanas has 230 Alliance and 40 Horde. Nightfall has 130 Alliance and 40 Horde. Obsidian Edge has 121 Alliance and 39 Horde. Keep in mind these numbers come from logged level 60 raids. Then there is another US East server next to it called Barman Shanker. They have 156 Alliance and 100 Horde at 60 raiding in Season of Mastery. So what does this tell you in Europe? There are a total of 3,440 and in US 3,005 raiders in Season of Mastery player base in Classic WoW at the moment. Sure, this number will go up with more getting to 60 daily, and some are just ranking and raiding after their grind is over. But people will also quit. Some in my guild and pug runs have already quit Season of Mastery after reaching 60 and doing a few raids. In MMORPGs, a ton of players decide to quit after reaching endgame. Classic WoW is the same. If you liked it before and enjoyed it, you might not now. It's just the same pattern of gameplay. I myself think this info is shocking and thought some would be way more popular. Just take your server number and divide it by 40. That's how many raids are going on at the moment, as every season of Mastery Raid needs 40 people to remain competitive. Is this number a lot to you compared to TPC? What are your thoughts? Drop them in the comments. Let's compare it now to the Burning Crusade player base, the same way through Ironforge Pro. I'm just gonna go over the total player base and a few mega servers that have a good Alliance versus Horde player base, as I feel that gives the best view on the point I'm trying to make. Let's start with Europe player base in the Burning Crusade Classic and then do the American one after again. So in TBC Europe, there is one server very well known and it's Firemaw. Look at that player base. Crazy on both sides and it's just a server to be on. Gehennus looks like it's dying soon on Alliance side. Horde side looks fine. Firewood Village same thing, but then Alliance player base is good and the Horde side is dying hard. Mirage Raceway. Look at the numbers. Evenly split, right? But maybe not. I remember when my own server in Classic WoW started dying, going to 3k members on Alliance side in TBC. Everyone was saying it was dying, and indeed, eventually it did. Just Horde on there now, and maybe one or two Alliance guilds. Golmak, other way around, again, this used to be very popular server back in Classic WoW. From this information, Firemaw and Firewood Village looks like the best servers. Firewood only for Alliance player base though. There's also Phenoxis, which is also perfect, but it's a German server, so if you're from there, it is a good option. My advice is just to transfer to Firemaw and enjoy playing the game like it's supposed to be, with a big server and player base. Now let's go over the player base in America playing TBC. It is honestly all over the place. Feels like every server is on one side, just too big or dying soon. Sorry for being so negative guys, it's just what I saw happen to my server Razigor. You all must feel it a little bit in TBC. If you are on US East, Alliance, be on Benediction or Pagel. If you are Horde, be on Feralina. These two servers have the player base on just one side of the coin. For US West, I would recommend Alliance Grovelus and Horde Whitemane. I know this advice is not the greatest, as you will be on a one-sided server player base wise, but you can't blame Blizzard for these issues. I'm just giving you my thoughts on the best server to raid on, so you can enjoy the rest of your TBC adventure. What I think Blizzard should do. Open up free server transfers to all realms on Season of Mastery. If you are on King's Fall, let them come to Dreadnought, and just make one mega server. Honestly, the PvP hasn't been bad at all. I've maybe died a total of 5 times while running around the world in Classic WoW. Same for the American servers. If we want to reach Nax in Classic Season of Mastery, something has to be done. I know Blizzard has not allowed this yet, going from a PvE to a PvP server, but these stats do not look good for two of the biggest servers. That's not even talking about the ones that have a lower player base. For TBC, it is honestly a big mess. I would just merge the servers, as too many are one-sided. For example, just merge Benediction and Feralina together and you're done with that one. Maybe they will end up doing this close to TBC and at the start of the Wrath of the Lich King. Drop in the comments what you think Blizzard should do. What I think the player base should do in Season of Mastery or TBC. Choose what you want to do. Make a plan for yourself. Set up goals you want to achieve in the game. Be true to yourself. Can you make this happen? Can this be a reality with this player base? If not, restart. Or in TBC case, server transfer. Right now I'm preparing a third Molten Core pug roster myself and have a total blast in Season of Mastery. This pug will be GDKP. If you guys would like a video on it, drop it in the comments so I know what to focus on. Make sure to pump the Johannes subscribe stock. If you enjoyed the video, I would appreciate a like on this video. Thank you for watching and have a good one.